Alright, dude, so first, thank you, and thank you, Jack, for, like, giving me the most entertaining thing since, like, Bubba's World, I think, since I was 10, dude. So, yeah, whose idea was the vlog, and or BAM TV?
Jack. Jack's the man behind the camera, and we talked about it forever. We wanted to do something, and it just never like, fit and worked out, and I think, like, once I got to GasGas and felt like I found my home and stuff, it was like, all right, let's do this now. I feel settled and ready to go, and Jack definitely pushed me to do it, which I'm really glad he did because I wasn't sure, and luckily it's been a good hit. I'm glad everyone likes it, and luckily it's just natural and it's easy. Like, me and Jack are buddies, so it's just like, it's just fun. Just a lot of fun and enjoyable.
All right, so I have, like, a lot of friends that are, like, outside of the industry, you know, that don't pay too much attention to moto, but they watched it and they're like, dude, Barcia's, like, pretty badass. Like, so did, like, fans, like, during the outdoors start coming around more often?
You know, obviously with the COVID times and stuff, it's a little weird, like, unfortunately, but, like, people are stoked on it, and luckily, like, for me too, like, I feel like I have a, you know, good European following, and we went to the UK in the off season for a few weeks, like, had a lot of, like, friends that we have there, like, they're like, their kids are watching, like, people they know, and like, they get them to watch it, and everyone enjoys it. So yeah, I think it has brought, like, I feel like I've always had a good fan base, but I've, like, people can actually see the true me and, like, how I am. Like, you know, it's hard racing because you always have your helmet on, and they only, people only, like, see, you know, the riding and stuff. So to get to, you know, see the personality, and luckily this, like I said, this would seem like the right time to do it, and I feel like everything's linking up and everyone's stoked on it, and I'm glad people can see me be me, stupid.
All right, so Will's joined you. He credits a lot of that to you wanting him there. What were you, like, kind of like, hey, can you come help me out with this?
Yeah, you know, I felt like the whole team was good, and like I said, we've added a few new guys this year, and Will obviously is one of those guys. But for me, like, me and Will were teammates back in the day. We always had a lot of fun. I saw, like, what he was doing at the other teams he was at. I thought he was doing a really good job. So I told Kike, I was like, hey, like, just randomly, I don't know, I was like, Kike, I really like to get Will on the team. And he's like, I've been trying to get him forever. And I was like, oh, well, let's harass him. We really had to bother Will a lot, but, you know, now it seems like 100%, like, he's the happiest he's been, I feel like, and for us and the team, like, it's been a pleasure working with him, and it's good to have him back on board, and brings the fun out, that's for sure.
All right, so with that, he obviously does a lot for you off the bike. Does that mean you're going to be based out of SoCal for the majority of the year?
Yeah, probably so. You know, I've been out here in California doing a little training camp and stuff. Obviously, I consider Florida home no matter what. Like, that's just where I'm at, where my home base is. Got my track and stuff there. But yeah, I definitely spending some time out here. Just, you know, being around the team is super important these first couple of years. And I've, you know, really enjoyed being around them and seeing everyone every day. And then, like, training with Michael and Pierce in the riding has been definitely awesome for me, and I think it hopefully helps them as well. So yeah, it's definitely good to train out here, have fun, get used to the hardback dirt and stuff like that.
But Bandland's not going away, right?
No, you know, I had thoughts about selling it, and it was kind of like a lot of Yahoo's just like, oh yeah, we'd like to have that, that'd be cool. And then the other day I had someone actually, like, serious into it, and we're not gonna do it. We're gonna keep it. And it's like, I kind of built my career, like, obviously my career was started before that place, but I feel like I took my career to the next level there. A lot of good memories, my parents stay there a lot, and it's just a special place, and I like to, you know, maybe one day do some just cool stuff there.
Sweet. All right, so, like, dude, I don't know, maybe a year ago now, we filmed your sprinter.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But it's like version 2 now, right?
Yeah, we're at.
What'd you change?
Yeah, custom outfits is absolutely awesome, Todd there. So, like, I went gung-ho. I wanted, like, everything in there, and I never had a short sprinter. So it was, like, for my dogs, obviously I have two Great Danes, so they're massive. So it just, like, it wasn't, like, the perfect layout for the dogs, and it was fine for me. Like, when I went to track by myself and or with Amber and the dogs were there, it was fine, but I just wanted more open concept, and we pretty much took the wall out and got rid of some stuff, and now we just have four, you know, driver passenger seat, two captain chairs, and that's, like, a really, like, the cabinets, and it's just really clean and open, and I'm able to throw my stuff in there way easier, and most of all, the dogs are happy. They just crash on the floor in their beds, and yeah, definitely. Todd just, he knocked out of the park. He did exactly what I said and what I wanted, and couldn't be happier with it.
All right, so let's talk about the team a little bit. GasGas, this whole thing is fun.
Yep.
Was that like, did that come about because of you, or just so coincidence?
I think it was just a coincidence, honestly. Like, KTM is, the main brand, Sirius. I don't know, the Husky brand is Sirius too, I feel like. Which Sirius is, there's nothing wrong with Sirius. Like, we want to be Sirius, win races, do all that. That's sick. But we're just like, this is a fun team. And, the brand itself is awesome, and it's new, and we're just like, it's really cool that I was able to come to the GasGas brand when I did, because I feel like, I'd like to think I'm fun and like to have a good time and go win races. And it's just like, and the BAM TV, and it's like I said, all of it came in circles. So I don't think it was because of me, but I like to think I have fun, so let's keep it going and build a cool brand. And people seem really stoked on it, and I see GasGas all the time now, and we just want to go win races and championships and have fun.
All right, sweet. So KTM Husky introduced this new chassis about a week ago now. So obviously you're not going to be on it for this year, but I kind of think that could be an advantage for you. Like, you get to spend another year on this bike, right?
Yeah, for me, it's great how it works out. The KTM Husky guys get to, work out the bugs or whatever. Not the bugs, but just, do the testing and all that stuff, the hard work, and I get to ride my old bike. I only have 1 year on it, so... I'm relaxed. Am I not relaxed? Oh, they're mad I'm too relaxed. Like, I'm just having a good time. Fun. It's a good, all right. No, this is relaxed. All right.
There we go.
Sorry, guys, for the slouch in the chair. It's been a long day. I'm just trying to have a relax, but this has been a nice, calm interview. Yes, so not having a new bike, it works out for me great. I get to focus on just making my bike last year, a little bit better or whatever, and make it comfort for myself. And I have a year under my belt, and now I just go out there and race and have fun and don't have to worry about anything too crazy. Just fine tune it here or there, and in a couple of years, I'll be on that thing.
Sweet. So, hey, any changes in your program this year?
Not really any big changes, just having Will on board. That's really the biggest change. Other than that, not too much, which I feel like, I did the training kind of myself last year, and this year I was just able to kind of voice my opinions to Will, and we built a program together, and it's been great. I don't think there's been any negative to anything I've done coming into this new season. Just a few little changes here or there and a little different crew, but honestly, it's awesome.
All right, lastly, about a month away from A1. Could it be four in a row? Is that what it is? Is that what it would be at?
That's what they're saying. Yeah. I tell everybody, I mean, that would be cool. I don't know how I've won three in a row. It's weird. It's kind of crazy, but obviously I go out there and do my best, but the big goal, there's a big picture, and it's definitely not winning the first race. It's I'd rather win the last race than the first race, to be honest with you. But yeah, we're gonna go after it no matter what. We'll see what happens, but definitely looking at the big picture.
All right, thanks.